We could go another way.
You're not serious. The creatures immerse you into the world that is Avatar.
There's no way you're getting me on that.
In the Avatar universe, almost all animals are hybrid creatures.
Otter penguin.
Shark squids.
Sky bison.
A winged lemur.
Vegemal.
It's a fun detail that fans really love, that I really love. So we started with imagery from the animated series and said, okay, what are real world representations of these visual ideas? And from there, built this library of visual information and language that we would then use to inform the physical and the digital builds of all the creatures.
Appa!
He is my best friend. Sorry, Katara.
Yep, yep!
On screen, Appa is a flying 10-ton bison. Off screen, he is half back on a mechanical bull controlled by people to make him seem like he's moving.
I've had some of my best days on Appa. It feels like you're flying through the air, which is a childhood dream.
And action! We try to keep as much live action as possible. One thing we wanted to stay true to is the silhouette of Appa as he's flying. So we use a manatee for the tail because of the way the manatee swims in the water. And then also we looked at the buffalo for the eyes and for the horn.
And on set, we had a full-sized Appa head, but it has no emotion to it. Gordon did an amazing job just relating to this thing. And our VFX team did an amazing job of bringing that emotion to the character of Appa so it matches with what Aang is doing in the scene.
You want to join us, Momo?
Momo is our very cute winged lemur who loves food and has some great banter with Sokka.
Bet you taste like chicken.
One of the biggest challenges with Momo was taking this creature that I loved the animated version of and making it feel real. So we referenced a lot of different lemurs and monkeys for performance because we didn't want to lose all that personality.
We worked on his eye sizes because saw about how emotive Momo can be.
We have a little furry ball that we use for reference, but the actors are acting with nothing else there and Momo is completely created in the computer.
Badgermole.
The Badgermole. In our world, just a tennis ball, but Gawandio and Ian did an amazing job.
For the badger mole, we wound up going over to the bear because that would help us with the weight. And then also his mouth, because his mouth gets really close to camera. And we really wanted to articulate his mouth to make sure it was believable, even for like the gradation in his teeth, which was really fun.
The ostrich horse on set is actually a stunt vehicle, and there's a stunt driver underneath our actors that are on top of a saddle.
Ostrich horses are ridiculously cool. They have frenetic movements, but then also when he's walking, he needs to be pristine, but it needs to also have weight and feel heavy.
It's fun getting to see the world of the Avatar come to life.
I hope that fans will be super excited when they see it. Like, oh my God, no way.
That is one big birdie.
Audiences will love the characters, the emotional journey, the storyline, the epic action, the humor.
Please tell me that he's saying, welcome friends.
That's not what it's saying.
But I have a feeling they're gonna love Appa the most. Or Momo. One of the two. That's what they always say.
Don't worry, kid. You don't have to do this alone. You have me, Tara, and a flying ball of fur. What more do you need? Really?